Preservatives are chemical substances that are added to pharmaceutical preparations in order to prevent or limit microbial contamination. If pharmaceutical preparations themselves are not antimicrobial in nature, antimicrobial preservatives can be added during the formulation. Depending on the type of product, one or more preservatives can be added. Preservatives must be added particularly to multidose pharmaceutical preparations, as they are exposed multiple times during their shelf life. While choosing the preservative for a particular product, it is important to consider its compatibility with other components of the product and packaging materials. Pharmaceuticals are not the only industry that use preservatives. Preservatives are also used in the food and cosmetic industries. However, the addition of preservatives does not encourage compromising good manufacturing practices. The preservative efficacy test is also known as the antimicrobial effectiveness test. The test determines the antimicrobial activity of a product and evaluates how effectively the product withstands microbial contamination during usage. The antimicrobial activity of a product in its final container shall be investigated throughout its shelf life. The test comprises of inoculation of a certain number of microorganisms into the product, storing the inoculated product at a specified temperature, withdrawing the sample at specified time intervals, and counting the microorganisms in the withdrawn sample. The preservative efficacy of the product is considered to be acceptable if there is a decrease or no increase in the microbial population. The acceptance criteria in terms of decrease in microbial population varies with the type of product. The test should be demonstrated during the development of the product to determine the effectiveness, and during the stability studies to determine the effectiveness is stable over time. The first step in the preservative efficacy test is to develop a method for the neutralization of the preservative of the product to be tested. Because the residual preservative in the product will suppress the viable microorganisms that are to be counted. Although the test method recommendations are the same in all the pharmacopoeia, there are some differences in the microorganisms used in the test and the acceptance criteria. In this chapter, we shall be taking the European pharmacopoeia as a reference. Before initiating the test, An inoculum should be prepared for each organism that is going to be challenged. The European Pharmacopoeia recommends using these microorganisms. Prepare a suspension of these microorganisms, which will give 10 to the power of 5 to 10 to the power of 6 microorganisms per milliliter when inoculated in the product container. The volume of inoculum should not exceed 1% of the volume of the product. This means, if the volume of the product is 10 milliliters, the inoculum volume should be 0.1 milliliters. If possible, use the original product containers for the inoculation of microorganisms. Use separate product container for each microorganism. Inoculate the microorganisms directly into the product container and store the container for 28 days at ambient temperature, protected from light. At different time intervals, collect 1 milliliter of sample directly from the product container. Collect the sample immediately after the culture inoculation for the 0-hour enumeration. And then, collect after 6 hours, 24 hours, 7 days, 14 days, and finally, on the 28th day. At each time interval, perform a 10-fold serial dilution of the sample and enumerate the viable microorganisms by plate count or membrane filtration method. Use SCDA for bacterial cultures and SDA for fungal cultures. The media should be capable of growth promoting. Incubate the SCDA plates at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius for 24 to 48 hours and SDA plates at 20 to 25 degrees Celsius for 3 to 5 days. After the incubation period, count the number of surviving microorganisms and calculate the log reduction using this formula. Here, A represents the initial microbial count and B represents the obtained microbial count at the current time point. Let us assume we have inoculated 10 to the power of 6 cells into the product container. At the 24-hour time point, we obtain a microbial count of 10 to the power of 3. Then, the log reduction will be log 10 to the power of 6 divided by 10 to the power of 3, which will give a 3 log reduction. As mentioned earlier, ensure that any antimicrobial activity of the product is eliminated by dilution or by adding specific neutralizers in the medium, which is used for the recovery of survived microorganisms. The method should be able to demonstrate the reduction in the microbial count due to the preservatives. Remember that the neutralization of preservatives is important at the time of enumeration of the microbial count at each time point. Neutralizers should not be added at the time of culture inoculation in the product. The acceptance criteria differ with the type of products. For example, in the case of parenteral preparations, the European Pharmacopoeia recommends that there should be a 2-log reduction on the 6th hour and a 3-log reduction on the 24th hour for bacteria. There should be no recovery on the 28th day. For fungi, there should be a 2-log reduction on the 7th day and no increase in population on the 28th day. In justified cases, if the A criteria cannot be attained, the B criteria must be satisfied.